Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video here at Architects3DP. Today we're going to be reviewing a new laser engraver with a couple accessories that will make using your machine at home much safer. As you may have recognized from the intro, it is the COMGO Z1 laser engraver together with the Honeycomb working table and the cover. All the products have been provided by COMGROW, which you will find linked down in the description. So the products came inside these three boxes, which are quite small as you can see. The Honeycomb table, the cover, and the laser engraver itself. So leaving these boxes aside, I'm going to start by unboxing the Honeycomb table, which as you can see comes with some adhesive feet, and the material parts are perfectly wrapped in protective plastic. After 20 minutes unwrapping the plastics, here we have some more protective films. Once all of them are out, we'll place the metallic base, then the Honeycomb itself on top, and finally the plastic corners to separate it from the floor. I'm going to stick the protectors on each of the corners and turn them upside down just like that. Now our table is safe from any scratches. Here we go, it is stable in place and it won't go anywhere. So I'm going to put it aside and continue with another box, that is going to be the laser engraver cover by COMGROW. When we cut it open, the first we find inside is a couple of gloves. I have pretty big hands and they fit me, so good job COMGROW. Continuing with the unboxing, next we'll find some paperwork with the instructions, the cover plastic, some plastic components, and the structural pipes. These metallic pipes come labeled with different letters as you can see, what will be useful for the assembly following the instructions. The assembly is pretty straightforward. You will need to assemble the extensions for both the L and W profiles. Then pick up the H pipes and insert one of the plastic corners on each end of the tube for all of them. The 3W profiles will go in this configuration, so we'll connect them to the H profiles. And finally, we'll pick up the L profiles and we'll connect both assemblies together just like that. It looks that we are missing a tube right here on the front, but here's where we're going to insert the two short tubes included in the back. And we have the structure complete. We insert the two plastic caps at the ends for security, and we are now ready to open the cover itself and install it in place. It has a window-like surface that looks like a real finger magnet, so I'm going to put on the gloves to continue. It looked very plasticky, but once in place, it looks quite good, right? Now we'll turn it around and we'll connect the Velcros, for what I'm going to take out the gloves. Here we go, guys. Our laser engraver cover is almost ready to go. Now we'll plug the air extraction device right here using the provided bolts and nuts, aligning everything together. And now yes, guys, our cover is complete. So for the laser work, we'll set the base in place, then the laser, and the cover on top. We'll be able to use the zippers to set the materials in place and so on, when the machine is not running. So these devices are so cool, but we can't use them without the laser engraver itself, and it is what we are going to unbox next. But before going for it, I want to present you today's video sponsor, PCBWay. PCBWay is your website to get your PCB prototypes the easy way. And especially now that they are running their 2022 PCBWay Christmas Big Sale. If you go to their promo page at PCBWay.com, clicking in the top banner on their website, or also through the link that you will find down in the description, you will find all kinds of advantages, such as free Christmas coupons, free prototype for Christmas theme design, huge Christmas sales up to 50% off for PCB and assembly orders, as well as up to 50% off for 3D printing and CNC machining, special sales in PCBWay store, and a call for Christmas projects where you can get up to 100 USD in coupons. Alright guys, back to the box. When we open it, we find a GT2 belt here on top, and I don't know why. Directly underneath the foam, we can basically find every component of the laser, starting with some paperwork for the instructions, and more papers that contain a diagram of the main board. Pretty cool. Next, a couple of gloves, a piece of transparent acrylic, and four metallic legs in anodized aluminum. The laser head itself, with the laser protector properly covered with a film, that goes right here with magnets. Next, we'll find a white cardboard box with the power brick inside, together with the power cord. Then some bags with components, and a USB-A to USB-B cable as usual. Next we'll find 5 sheets of what looks like 3mm basswood, very cool. Then we find two 20x20 profiles, a 40x20 profiles with the brand, and another one with no branding. Finally, here we have the X-axis gantry that comes already connected to the brain of the machine, as you can see. Unboxing done, guys! Now let's have a look at those smaller objects we unboxed before starting with assembly. So in the first plastic bag, we'll find a couple GT2 tinning belts, together with some zip ties and a cable clip. We'll also have some more tools that we'll use for the assembly of the machine. In the second plastic bag, we'll find the plastic caps for the ends of the 20x20mm profiles, all the necessary bolts and nuts for the build, that by the way, they don't have any tag or anything to identify them, and finally, an 8GB microSD card, together with the reader that reads at least 30 types of memory cards. And now yes, we're going to start with the assembly, guys. I want to have a little bit of time at the end of the video to test the laser, so I won't go into very small details for the build. So first of all, we'll put together these four profiles with the longer bolts. Next, we'll insert the X-axis gantry, and how not, I can't do it. Since the instructions are way too basic, and they don't explain where I have to go the Y-axis end stop, we of course installed it in a wrong place. So now I have to disassemble everything and assemble everything back, rotating the two 20x20mm profiles just like that. Now the sensor is at the bottom of the right corner of the machine, as you can see. And now yes, install the X-axis gantry from the back, sliding it to the front. Next, we'll install the electronic box on the bottom of the laser right here, using the provided bolts, just like that. The Allen key is too short for this assembly, so the assembly will take a while. After that, we'll install the four metallic legs on each corner. They will be held in place by two small bolts, one with a T-nut inserted in the 20x20mm profile, and the other one will screw directly to the threaded hole. We'll repeat the same process on each of the four corners. And that was the last one. Now we'll rotate the laser back in place, and we're going to continue by installing the GT2 tinning belts that will move the Y-axis. The machine has two motors that are located on each of the ends of the X-axis, and in order to work, we'll run the belt just like that through these pulleys, and we'll later attach it on both ends of the axis. So the first end, we'll insert the square nut and the bolt on top, and tighten everything together. That way, we'll have this end perfectly attached, as you can see. We'll repeat the same process for the other end of the profile, just like before. And once done, we'll repeat the same process on the other side. First we'll pass the belt, and then we'll attach it from both sides. Once done, we'll insert the four plastic caps on the ends of the 20x20mm profiles. For that, you just have to push them in place and they will stay in just like that. That was the last one, guys. All the frame is complete, guys. The only thing we need to do yet is to install the laser head in place and connect everything together. So we'll remove the four thumb screws holding the mount in place. And then, using three of the smaller bolts, we'll insert them through the mount of the back into the laser head just like that to assemble everything together. Once done, we'll install the magnetized cover, and we will insert the four thumb screws back in place, holding the laser head to the X-axis carry, as you can see. Now we need to connect all the cables, starting with the two on the laser module. Just like that. Then we'll plug in the Y-axis end stop here at the bottom. Here we go. Now we'll stick the cable clip to the leg on the bottom right corner of the machine, as you can see. And finally, we'll run the cables through and we'll close the clip. Here we go, guys. The X-axis can move perfectly, as you can see, as well as the Y-axis. Oops, I forgot to plug in the two Y-axis motors. I'm doing that real quick. What I was saying, perfect movement for both the Y-axis as well as the X-axis of the machine. The focus distance, however, will need to be set manually using the thumb screws, as you can see. Alright guys, so the machine assembly is complete, and I can't wait to watch it working. But before, we're going to bring back all the accessories we unboxed at the beginning of the video. So we'll place the honeycomb table at the bottom, then we'll bring the laser head up a little bit. Place the material to cut in place, and last step will be to cover it with the laser cover, that we can now open to finish all the settings, before closing the zippers back and starting the laser work. As I always do, here we are in the workbench to make sure I won't screw up the white table, and I need to start with the testing. So after turning it on, This time, using light burn, the laser will automatically auto-home. Then, after having set the material in place, focus the laser and start the engraving work. Here you can see what is happening. The laser does not work. I actually recorded all the previous footage of this video 1.5 months ago, when I contacted COMGROW about this situation, and that's when they sent over a new updated laser head that I have received just a few hours ago. As you can see, I have the new laser head right here. The connectors are not the same as the original, and they included an adapter that I'm going to try before assembling it in place. So after turning on the machine and starting the engraving work, as you can see now, the laser is perfectly working as expected. So I'm going to quickly switch the laser heads, and I will see you in a moment. So after having set the materials in place and focused the laser, the next step is gonna be to install the laser cover. By the way, since the cover window is already a protector for your eyes, I have removed the red cover at the bottom of the laser head. Anyways, you should always keep using the provided protective goggles. It definitely feels very safe with this cover installed. So we can open the zippers of the cover to align all the materials and so on, and then close it back before starting the engraving work. I have started it, and I'm gonna let you with a quick time lapse. Once done, I'm going to frame the cutting work and straightly go for it. This is real speed footage, guys. As you can see, this laser head works as a charm. I'm going to wait till it finishes. And here we have our wooden card ready. As you can see, the quality of the engraving and cutting is just insane. It went quite deep too. Excuse me for misplacing the material properly, by the way. Here you have, guys, a closer look at the laser work. As you can see, since we're not using an air pump for the nozzle, the cuts have a dark area around, but the rest is just perfect. For the next test, I framed the black acrylic dust, and I'm going to make both the engraving and cutting tests. As you can see, both tests worked out perfectly, cutting through the material pretty easily. Check out this great result. Alright guys, so after 2 months in the making, we have no more time to make more tests with this machine in this video. I hope you enjoyed with this content, and to finish, just please make sure you are subscribed to the channel, consider supporting our work on Patreon as all these amazing people do, and as always, see you in the next video.